Hello everyone, welcome to Computer Science Hub. Our subject is Computer Fundamentals and topic Computer Codes. This is the part 1 video of Computer Codes, and in this video we will be discussing about 3 types of computer codes. They are ASCII, EBCDIC and Unicode. Let's start. Representation of characters. All digital computers have to handle alphabets and special characters besides decimal numbers that we already know, right? Let's consider our keyboard. In our keyboard, there are alphabet keys and there are numeric keys, there are special keys, right? So our computers have to handle alphabet, special characters, numbers, etc. There are 26 English alphabets, then 10 decimal digits and several special characters like plus, minus, star, dollar, etc. In order to code these binary numbers, one needs a string of binary digits. That's because our computers know only sequence of zeros and ones. So we have to convert everything we type into form of strings of zeros and ones. That is a form of binary digits. There are different methods to represent characters, and they are ASCII, first one. Okay. So we are going to discuss about the first method of character representation, that is ASCII. The code called ASCII is pronounced as ASCII, which stands for. So this definition, this expansion is very important. ASCII stands for American Standard Code for Information Interchange. A for American Standard Code for Information Interchange. It uses 7 bits to represent each character in computer memory. When we press a key A, okay, English alphabet A key, then it is stored as its corresponding 7 bits binary numbers in computer memory. So every character is stored as 7 bits binary form. The ASCII representation has been adopted as a standard by the US government and it is widely accepted. And this is a very familiar method, this is a most commonly used method for this representation of characters, and a unique integer number is assigned to each character. This number called ASCII code of that character is converted into binary for storing in memory. In case of ASCII, a unique integer number is assigned for each character, and this character is known as, this number is known as ASCII code, and that ASCII code is converted into binary for storing in memory. Okay. For example, ASCII code of A is 65. Okay. ASCII code for this capital A, for small letter A it is different, for capital A it is 65. Its binary equivalent in 7 bits is 1000001. When we press this capital A, this code is stored in memory. 1 1 2 3 4 5, 5 zeros and 1. This code is binary equivalent, stored in memory, and 65 is the ASCII code of capital A. Since there are exactly 128 unique combinations of 7 bits, we know how many combinations we can make with 7 bits, that is 2 raised to 7. 2 raised to 7 is 128. So we can make 128 combinations with 7 bits, which means this 7 bit code can represent only 128 characters. But in our keyboard, there are more than this 128 characters. We know even alphabets are having small letters and capital letters. And there are many special keys and numeric keys, etc. So this 128 characters is not enough for us to represent all the characters. Another version is ASCII 8. Okay, so this is the latest version. Another version is ASCII 8. That is also known as extended ASCII. Here it uses, as the name indicates, it uses 8 bits instead of 7 bits for each characters. So with 8 bit we can make 2 raised to 8, that is 256 different characters, 256 combinations. Therefore we can store 256 different characters. For example, the letter in represented by 01. So here the letter A is represented by 0 1 5 0s and 1. And letter B, capital B, by 0 1 0 0 0 0 and 1 0, so on. So So here we are using 8 bits to represent a character. So we can make 256 different characters. We can represent 256 characters. ASCII code is enough to represent all of the standard keyboard characters. These 256 characters are enough to represent all of the standard keyboard characters. Next category. So that is all about ASCII. This is an American standard. It is widely accepted one. First, we have used 7-bit ASCII code, and now we are using ASCII 8. Using ASCII 8, we can represent 256 different characters. Next is EBCDIC. Okay. It's EBCDIC code. It stands for E for Extended Binary Coded Decimal Interchange Code. Extended Binary Coded Decimal Interchange Code, also known as EBCDIC code. This is similar to ASCII and is an 8-bit code used in computers manufactured by IBM. So this is specific to IBM machine computers. Okay, IBM machines. It is capable of course, encoding 256 characters. If ASCII coded data is to be used in a computer which uses EBCDIC representation, it is necessary to transform ASCII code to EBCDIC code. So this ASCII is an American standard code and it is widely accepted, but in machines with IBM machines, in IBM machines, they are using EBCDIC code. So ASCII coded data has to be converted to EBCDIC representation in order to run in IBM machines. Okay. Similarly, and vice versa, and ABCDIC coded data is to be converted to ASCII for running in ASCII machines. Okay. Next is ISCII. Okay. ISCII stands for, this is Indian, I for Indian, A for American Standard Code for Information Interchange, and this is Indian Standard Code for Information Interchange, or Indian Script Code for Information Interchange. This is an encoding scheme for representing various writing systems of India. This uses 8 bits for data representation. It was evolved by a standardization committee under the Department of Electronics during 1986-88 era and adopted by the Bureau of Indian Standards, BIS. So this is adopted by this ISCII is adopted by BIS, and it is an 8-bit bits of data representation scheme, and it's an encoding scheme used for representing various writing systems. Nowadays, ISCII has been replaced by Unicode. So this ISCII is replaced by Unicode now. Then what is Unicode? Using 8-bit ASCII, we can represent only 256 characters. This cannot represent all characters of written languages of the world and other symbols. For English, this 256 characters are enough. We can use this to ASCII method to represent all the English and all the mathematical things. But for all the written languages of the world and for other symbols, this cannot represent. This ASCII, 8-bit ASCII, even this 8-bit ASCII cannot represent all characters. For that, Unicode is developed. It aims to provide a standard character encoding scheme which is universal and efficient. Not ISCII is evolved for written languages in India. Okay, but it was replaced by Unicode, right? And this Unicode is universal and it is efficient and it is used for supporting all the characters of written languages of the world. It produces a unique number of for every character, no matter what the language and platform be. Okay. Unicode originally used 16 bits. Okay, using 16 bit, we can represent 65536 characters. Okay. It is maintained by a non-profit organization called the Unicodes Consortium, and the consortium first published the version 1.0.0 in 1991 and continues to develop standards based on that original work. Nowadays, Unicode uses more than 16 bits and hence it can represent more characters. Unicode can represent characters in almost all written languages of the world. Okay. This is all about Unicode. So we have discussed three representations. First one is ASCII and the second version ASCII 8. Then Next is EBCDIC for IBM machines. Then ISCII. Then last one is the unique code. It is the mostly accepted one and it is used to represent all the written languages of the world. And here it uses 16 bits. So it can represent up to 65,536 different characters. Okay. And it was developed by Unicode Consortium. Okay. Hope the concept is clear. Thank you.